Social distancing on Sydney trains, impossible during peak hour. Commuters crammed into carriages as services were drastically scaled back due to rail workers walking off the job. This as New South Wales recorded a rapid spike in cases.
We're definitely seeing the start of a new wave. Last year, when case numbers went skyrocketing, so did hospitalisations. This year, because we have such a high proportion of our population vaccinated, the same thing won't happen.
A Newcastle nightclub at the centre of a new cluster has seen its positive case numbers skyrocket to at least 200. The city on alert after new venues were flagged as close contact exposure sites.
We are of the belief that Omicron transmission is accounting for our increased case numbers at present.
Health authorities say they won't backflip on tomorrow's planned lifting of restrictions. The unvaccinated will be free to return to hospitality venues, gyms and non-essential retail. Density limits at venues will no longer apply. Mask wearing will be scrapped in shops and QR code check-ins will only be required in high-risk settings.
Why don't we wait 2 or 3 weeks to see what's happening with Omicron and then make the decision? But no, they're going ahead with, relaxing restrictions. I mean, this is just a silly way of doing it.
Amid growing concerns, the state's health minister says the message is clear.
COVID has not gone away, so take it very seriously and get the booster shot. I'm very concerned that not enough people are actually understanding the benefit of getting the booster. A third shot of vaccine is going to make all the difference.
Meanwhile, Tasmania is gearing up to open its border to fully vaccinated travellers from hotspots tomorrow.
I think right now, when we're at a point where we are one of the highest vaccinated places in the world, that the time is right to reopen with the measures that we have in place.
And in the Northern Territory, case numbers dropped after yesterday recording its highest daily increase since the start of the pandemic. One confirmed case and three possible cases in remote communities have been detected.
These positive cases do need to be confirmed by our laboratories, but we believe because of the close contacts that they have had that they're genuine cases.
Rochelle Harrison-Pless, SBS World News.